Well, I'm finally ready to do my introduction to welding for woodworkers. Before I get started on it, I want to say that I'm inside my woodworking area of my shop and not outside where I normally do my welding, and that's because there's a major construction project going on about 2 blocks from my house, and the racket outside is just too serious for me to deal with. Well, what I want to talk about first, and let me say this right off the bat too, I have some notes hung up, and so I don't mean to be shifty-eyed during this thing, but I'm trying to consolidate this introduction into a simple thing, so I do have some notes that I need to look at. So I apologize for that if that's distracting. Okay, so this is an introduction to gas-shielded MIG welding for woodworkers. And so this is for anybody that wants to integrate welding into their shop fixtures, or perhaps build some furniture that, you know, will have, so you'll mix steel and wood together. And so what I want to talk about first is that I'm not a welder. I know a few things that I've been taught by very experienced certified welders, but I am not a welder. I'm a woodworker. And so I want to just make sure that you understand that, and take everything that I say and know that it can probably be improved upon. And I welcome hearing ways that I can improve my welding skills, because every day is a new learning experience, and so I want to get better. But I want to help people get over that hump of experimenting with this amazing process. But as woodworkers, we're already really good at some of the most important aspects of welding and steel fabrication, and that is cutting accurately to a line, layout, design, sequence of work. We already know those things, and they are very, very similar in both disciplines of woodworking and steel fabrication. Okay, before we really get started with this series, though, I want to talk a little bit about safety. Welding can be dangerous. It can actually even be fatal, and it can also damage your health, and if you don't take certain precautions. If you've watched any of my woodworking videos, you know that I'm not a safety nanny. I firmly believe that each person is basically responsible for their own safety and health, and you know, we all are going to be exposed to certain amounts of risk when you embark on working around tools and machines. But I just think that using logic and good judgment and common sense and understanding cause and effect can really mitigate those dangers. You know, because I've been basically working around tools and machines 7 days a week since I was 25, and I'll be 54 this summer. So I've never really seriously been injured. I've had some injuries, but you know, I've got all my fingers, and I've never been maimed, and so I feel that a lot of that is because just using good common sense and you know, kind of being in the moment when I'm working. But so let me talk about welding first, about what some of the things we have to consider are. Welding is an electric process, and you know, any kind of electric process, there is the risk of shock and potentially even electrocution. And so there are some real basic things that we should never do when we're welding. We should never weld with wet gloves or clothes on. You know, water conducts electricity. You never ever weld barefoot. That would mean you would form a pathway to the earth, and where electricity could pass through you, and it could be a very serious situation. Don't ever weld while you're standing in water. Don't ever weld wearing synthetic fabrics. Don't weld wearing tennis shoes with synthetic fabric on them. Hot stuff can melt right through nylon and synthetic fabrics, or not only melt through them, but actually catch on fire. And so you want to stick with cotton, wool, or leather. And I'm in Texas, and I'm a cotton guy because it's so hot here. And whenever I weld, I'm always covered up. I wear long sleeves. I protect myself. I protect myself in as many ways as I possibly can. I wear a leather apron to protect myself from hot spatter, and also from the incredible ultraviolet light that is given off by the welding process. And this light is so bright that it can damage your skin or your eyes if you do not take proper precautions. And that also means that you need to protect bystanders around you while you're welding, making sure that they understand that they cannot look at the welding arc. And then also protect pets that may not have the sense to not look at the arc. So whenever I'm welding, I put my dogs inside. They are not around at all. And I've got my hood down. I can't see what they're looking at. I don't want them watching me and looking even in the general direction of that incredibly bright light. So some of the basic items that you're going to need to have as a welder. Well, the first thing you're going to need to have is a welding cap. And the reason you need a welding cap is because the welding process, this MIG welding process, while you're welding, there is a cascading, bouncing cacophony of little molten BBs that are produced during the welding process. And these things bounce everywhere. They will get everywhere. They will stick to things that you don't want them to stick to. So don't have anything like good sets of glasses or tools like nice rulers or anything around you that you do not want these molten metallic BBs to attach to, because they will ruin things. You know, camera lenses, reading glasses. I'll leave my reading glasses out sometime and forget that I have them while my shield is down, and the little BBs bounce up and melt spots on the plastic. You know, but fortunately these are just throwaway $20 or $10 readers from Walgreens, so I pretty much trash them out about every 2 months anyway. So for me, that's not that big a deal. So you wear a welding cap because the little BBs are bouncing everywhere, and they'll bounce and get on top of your head, and they'll burn your scalp, and it's very, very irritating and distracting, and no one needs that. And you always wear safety glasses no matter what process you're doing. You wear your safety glasses. And you've seen me often where I wear my safety glasses and then I have to wear my readers on top so I can see what I'm doing. I've never been able to wear those safety glasses that have those little tiny readers inside built in. They're just not a big enough field of vision for me. And so I wear a leather apron when I'm welding, unless it's just so hot here in Texas that I can't take it. And one of the most often neglected aspects of welding, besides protecting yourself from the molten BBs. Oh, and on that same note, you always wear earplugs when you're welding, always, because those BBs are bouncing everywhere, and when they go down your ears, you've never felt pain like that. So you'll do that one time before you realize you need to wear earplugs. You could have that happen while you're in the middle of something. You could jerk, you could strain your neck, you could knock something over, or it could just be ugly. So just some simple earplugs that as these BBs are coming over you, they're shedding off, you know. Yeah, don't ever wear pants, breeches with cuffs in them. That's a place for fire to start, down in those cuffs. You know, I always wear just leather boots with no laces, where everything just gets shed off of the top of the leather boot. And so that's my thing. But one of the most often overlooked aspects and dangers of welding is the toxic vapors that are released. Now, this MIG welding that I use here, gas shielded MIG welding, is one of the cleanest processes there is. There is very little smoke involved with it. But still, the temperatures are so extreme in welding that any surface contamination that's on the metal, grease, old paint, things like that, that even though you think you've cleaned areas back, there's still going to be stuff there. Those vaporize and will come right up into where you're working, and the last thing you want to do is breathe those things in. So 3M makes a simple welding respirator that has these low profile cartridges on it that fit under the welding hood. And I always wear this. I never weld without this, because I've, you know, being a woodworker for almost 30 years, I've been around enough toxic stuff, dust, finish, you name it. I don't need to now have welding fumes on top of it. So a simple $15-$20 respirator like this, change the cartridges every couple months, and you know, just buy yourself a new body every couple years because they get kind of dirty and gross, and that's all you need. One of the other things to consider when welding is the unbelievable temperatures involved. It's pretty hard to grasp until you first start experimenting with welding. An oxyacetylene torch cuts at 6,400 degrees Fahrenheit, and that is really unbelievably hot. You know, steel melts at about 1,500 or 1,600 degrees. I mean, that's what a furnace is that will turn steel liquid. And so this is way, way hotter than that. And the MIG process is even hotter than that. That the temperature that's happening right at the end of the electrode. So it's a very, very unbelievable process of heat that you can potentially burn yourself, or you can start a fire. And so you always keep a good fire extinguisher handy, and you know, and really be aware that these kind of temperatures can be very, very dangerous, and you know, not only to yourself but to your property or someone else's property. You know, you often hear where grass fires were started, they said, oh, it was started by this welding spark, you know. So cascading sparks and things are going everywhere, and you know, dry grass and what have you. And so it is not something to joke with at all. But the heat is so intense that often when I'm welding, I'll put on a protective sleeve on my left arm which is always closer to the welding source for me. So this just gives me a little bit of protection. I generally, with my welder, since it's not a super high power welder, I 99% of the time I just weld with these driver's gloves on, these good Tillman driver's gloves, because they're real easy to take on and off, and they're loose, and so that the heat doesn't penetrate right to my fingers. But I will wear a welding glove on my left hand if I'm doing a lot of welding, and if I'm doing a lot of like really close welding for any period of time, I'll often slip this little heat shield on my left hand too, that you can pick up at any welding supply place. I use this a lot when I'm using the cutting torch too, because of just that radiant heat coming off of it. But these safety precautions that come on every box of welding supplies: fumes, electric shock, arc rays, and fire and explosion. These are real. These are real concerns to be aware of, and not anything to take lightly. So I really want you to be aware of that, and to really take precautions, because I don't want to be maimed. I don't want to be injured. I don't want to have my health damaged by breathing toxic Chinese grease, you know, vapors, and I'm sure you don't either. So it's a very, very minor thing to wear one of these when you're working, and to wear safety glasses and a cap and earplugs. I mean, it's just not that big a deal. And the reward of doing this, learning this process, is so great that you won't mind doing it at all. But let me give you an example of a common thing that can really, really damage your health, and in some cases can actually kill you. And that is welding galvanized steel. So steel that's been chemically dipped in a galvanizing process. It's steel that's been plated with this galvanized material. Now, when you weld that, the fumes that come off of that are incredibly toxic. And if you weld that, which I try to avoid almost completely, I try not to ever do it, but you can actually, if you breathe in the vapors from that, you can get what's called metal fume fever. And it can make you sick, it can make you feel stupid for days, it can make you run a fever and just feel terrible, and it can kill you. I mean, it can kill you in dosage. So, you know, it's really nothing to mess with. So you really, really, I really stress that you wear one of these respirators. And this is one of the things on all the welding series and things that I look at online. I don't know if I've ever seen a welder in any welding series online wearing a respirator while they were working. But when I got started welding, the people that taught me were very, very serious certified welders, and they took this very seriously. They were doing it every day, and they just, I mean, we couldn't go any further until I had my respirator, and that was just the way it was going to be. And so I'm really lucky that I learned how to do it right and do it safely from the get-go.
Thank you.